Hello friends, in this video we will see SAP PP introduction. In this SAP PP introduction, we will see the SAP PP, where it is used, how it is used, and who can learn SAP PP. And next, if you see this image, here four different types of industries is coming. In first image, if you see the bike manufacturing, next the car manufacturing company, the next the engine assembly is going on, and the next pharmaceutical company is manufacturing drugs. So in these four different types of industries, there are different processes are going on. So in bike assembly, there is the assembly of particular part in particular station is going on. For car assembly, the same. For engine assembly, there are different parts has been fitting towards the engine to assemble it. And in process industries, the processes is going on particular raw material to manufacture the drugs. Also foods processing is also come under the process industries. So all these production is going on, and there is some planning is required, and that planning has been done by the production planner. And SAP PP consultant and SAP PP is basically worked on production processes. How it is, how the production it is happened, how it will be go, how it will be the flow of the production, what the time is required for the production, what the material is required for the production, that all has been configured towards the SAP PP. So next, so SAP PP is coming under the logistic area. So in logistic area, the SAP PP is coming. So in SAP PP, there are production planning, and in SAP PP, there are some master data is also required. What the master data is there? So master data in SAP PP is like a material management, then like a work center, then capacity is over there, then routing is over there. So like this, the master data is going to keep in production planning. SAP PP is one of the important tool because of that only, because the all the required the basic material is put into this SAP PP module, production planning module. And SAP PP module supports the planning of production in day to day in industries for the business processes. SAP PP is the process of aligning forecasting and customer demand with the manufacturing facility to create production and procurement scheduling. So what it is, suppose we are having one industry which is demanding a particular manufacturing product. Okay. So for manufacturing some particular product, they are having the demands, like the demand is from the customer or the demand from the forecasting. If the demand from the customer, that will come towards the sales order. Okay. If the demand from the forecasting, that is the nothing but the plant independent requirement, and that will be go towards the production order, and then afterwards the production order will be do the production in that one. So the SAP PP is working under the different demand management also. In that we will see in coming videos, make to stock and make to order. Next, we will see that who can learn the SAP PP. There is no restriction for anybody to learn anything. But the thing is that your desire and commitment required for to learn. Anybody can learn in SAPPP. Manufacturing business processes. Okay, the industry's manufacturing business processes knowledge is required, but it is not a mandatory. Okay, so whatever the processes over there for particular industries, so that knowledge is required, but that is not like that you must should have that knowledge. That is not the scenario. So that knowledge will be advantage for you, but it is not mandatory. In this training, you will learn from the scratch. If you see SAPPP all modules from first video to the last video coming, then you will see the from scratch. I will be going to be delivered to you the each and every concept, and that will be helpful for you. You should have to learn not only configuration or user level purpose, but for day to day daily scenarios in industries. For that purpose, you should have to learn the SAPPP. SAPPP is a very one of the most important module in SAP, and that you should have to learn towards the business point of view, not only configuration point of view or not only the end user point of view.